All right, so let me try to write that down in a way that lets us summarize it. So I think what you're saying is when we did that one-dimensional case, it had the VC dimension was 1. When we did the interval, it was 2. When we did two-dimensional linear separators, it was 3. And you're wondering whether in 3 dimensions it would be 4.
Yes.
So that's a really good insight. Let me be a little bit more precise here. That the hypothesis spaces in each of these cases, here they were defined by this parameter theta. In the interval case, it was defined by A and B. In the two-dimensional case, it was defined by W and theta. And W was in 2 dimensions, so this was actually a vector of size 2. So each time we went up to do a different example, we actually added another parameter. And it looks like the VC dimension is the number of parameters.
Hmm.
So in a sense, it's the dimensionality of the space in which the hypotheses live. So it really fits very nicely. That doesn't exactly answer your question. It is the case that for a three-dimensional problem, there's going to be 4 dimensions. And so it turns out you are right, that for any d-dimensional hyperplane concept class or hypothesis class, the VC dimension is going to end up being d plus 1.
Oh, I see. And that's because the number of parameters that you need to represent a d-dimensional hyperplane is, in fact, d plus 1.
That's right. Yeah, D, the weights for each of the dimensions plus the theta, the greater than or equal to thing.